out of the north, and we're starting to get some more direction out of the northeast, which that makes me think that this is starting to be a wobble back to the west of that eye wall, and I do think we are going to get into the western side of the eye here in Houma. I am worried for the people here, though, for those destructive winds that are about to arrive with that eye wall. Grand Isle had a wind gust to 148 miles an hour before the anemometer broke. That was reported by a sheriff there in Grand Isle. It's very likely that those winds were probably pushing 200 miles an hour in gusts. And we're just starting to get the inner core of the hurricane here. Winds are starting to gust up to hurricane force here in Houma now. In gusts, you can see those clouds just ripping from north to south, starting to come out of a more of an easterly direction as well. There. These power lines are all going to come down here. Sheet metal is going to be flying through the air. Very dangerous storm, high end category 4, maybe even stronger than that as it's coming in. It's got a very compact eye as well, and a very dangerous eastern eye wall. Just pummeled Grand Isle there. That's going to move across the southern coastline of Louisiana here, and right where those big time southerlies meet the terrain, that is where the worst storm surge is going to happen. It could be 10 to 15 feet. Maybe even 20 feet up there in that eastern eye wall, likely Grand Isle, completely under several feet of water. Double-digit storm surge just submerged Grand Isle, and this thing is just beginning. It's going to continue to move west-northwest over the southern coastline of Louisiana and do a gradual turn to the north, and that's going to bring the dangerous side of the storm right over New Orleans.